Right from the beginning of civilizations, man has used natural materials. With the passage of time, he tried creating some of them exactly replica of the natural material. These natural materials are known as polymers. So friends, today I am going to discuss about polymers. We'll discuss all the aspects of polymers and the method of polymerizations. There will be questions in between which you can answer in the comment section. So welcome to my channel, Sony Singh Physics. Friends, if you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Press the bell button to get the notification as soon as possible. First, we will talk about what are polymers. To understand this, first we will compare the polymers with a paper garland. You might have made paper garland in your school. How did you make them? We take each piece of paper, connect to each other, and this until we get a chain of papers. We can understand polymer in the same way. Polymer is a giant molecule made up from smaller units. These smaller units are known as mers. Each unit is connected with a chemical bond. The property of a polymer depends upon how we make it and what are the materials we have used in it. Nowadays, we are surrounded with hundreds of polymers. The protein present in our body to the thermoplastic which is nearby us in each and every step. Where does the word polymer come from? Polymer is a Greek word. Poly means many and mer means units. Think of hospital equipment that are used for processes like sterilization. Any idea about the kind of polymers used in them as they need to withstand high temperatures? Some polymers are stable at very high temperatures. What are the qualities of them? Now we will look at that. The first one is all of them have a high intermolecular force. Second quality is they have a special network. And the third quality is all of them have additives. These additives are some extra chemical which get added in these polymers to increase their thermal stability. These polymers are usually known as high temperature polymers and can withstand a surface temperature greater than 150 degree. Polymers can be classified on the basis of source, structure, mode of polymerization and based on molecular forces. So these are the four categories on which we can classify any type of polymers. As per source, polymers are categorized into three: natural polymer, semi-synthetic polymer and synthetic polymer. Natural polymers are those polymers which is present in our environment naturally. And they are proteins in the human body, nucleic acids, then latex in the plant, cellulose in the plants. So there are many, but some of them I have written here. Semi-synthetic polymers are those polymers which present naturally, but we use a chemical method and treat them for some chemical properties enhancement. And the example is vulcanized rubber. Rubber is naturally present in our environment, but when we treat it with the sulfur to increase its thermal stability, it is known as vulcanized rubber. The third one is synthetic polymer. They are man-made polymers which we make in a lab. For example, plastic, nylon and Teflon. Here are some questions. Please answer these questions in the comment section. If a polymer is derived from two different monomers, then it is known as what? Second question is, Polyester is which type of polymer? Third question is Teflon is which type of polymer? And the fourth one is what was the first commercial use of nylon? Friends, I hope you have got some idea about polymers. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.